Electrical energy. Okay, up to we are studying about how to generate the electrical energy and how to transmit the electrical energy and how to distribute the electrical energy. So we are generating in generation subject. Okay, from which energy sources you can generate the electrical energy, and in transmission you can studied about how to transmit the electrical energy. In distribution, I think present the subject also running EDS, electrical distribution systems. Okay, how to distribute the electrical energy to the consumers. Okay, finally, so generation, transmission and distribution, finally you can use the electrical energy. Okay, so in which ways we are using the electrical energy? That means applications of a electrical energy. Okay, where you are using the electrical energy, in which application points of view you are using the electrical energy, that is total discussing about in utilization of electrical energy. Okay, so in worldwide, the electrical energy is used in mainly four purposes. Those are illumination, electric heating, electric welding and electric traction. Okay, so illumination is nothing but light. Okay, so electric heating is nothing but in heating purpose. Electric welding is nothing but in welding process. And finally, traction is nothing but in railways. Okay, in railways applications, how the electrical energy will be utilized. Those are all studied about in utilization of electrical energy. In utilization of electrical energy, the first unit is about illumination. Illumination is total, that is related to the light. In second unit, you can discuss it about the electric heating and welding. Okay, and third unit, you have discussing about the electrical traction one. And second unit, in fourth unit, you have discussed about the electrical traction two. And 15 unit, you can discuss about the economic aspects of utilization of electrical energy. Okay, these are the 5 units present in the utilization of electrical energy. Okay, so in UEE subject, you have total studied out about in which applications, okay, you are using the electrical energy. So the first one is illumination. In unit 1, total you have to discussing about the illumination. That is total about the light. See, coming to the contents of first unit, definitions. There is a lot of definitions related to the illumination. There will be some laws of illuminations, polar curves. So these all are the contents about the first unit. Okay. Light. So what is the light? Okay, see. Light is a form of electromagnetic energy radiation from the body, and human eye is capable of receiving it. Okay, so what is the light? Light is a form of electromagnetic energy radiated from a body and human eye capable of receiving it. Okay, that is nothing but light is nothing but this is a one electromagnetic energy which is radiated from our body. Okay, that means from which source? That is from human eye. So it is a capable of to see anything. That is nothing but the light. Light is a primary factor in the human life as well as all activities of human being ultimately depending upon the light. Okay, so human life, all activities will be depending upon the light. Okay, so see, various forms of incandescent bodies are the sources of light, and the light emitted by the such bodies depending upon their temperature. Okay, see, so different, so coming to human body or any object, so those having the different light capacities. For suppose a hot body about, so if suppose anything you can heat it up to 500 to 800 degree centigrade becomes a red hot. Okay, so so that means whenever you have heated that body, so whenever heated means whenever burning at the time, it will gives a red color. So if suppose you have more heated, so that means about 2500 to 3000 degree centigrade, the body becomes white hot. That means, so whenever you have burning with a very high temperature, that red color will becomes, that means finally it will be destroyed. Okay, so at that time it will becomes a white color. Okay, see, here while the body is red hot, the wavelength of the radiated energy will be sufficiently large and energy available in the form of heat. See, whenever, so the light will be in red color, so at that time it is a sufficiently large, so at that time it is useful for the energy available for the human beings. If the temperature will be increases, the body changes from red to hot. That means white hot state, the wavelength of the radiated energy becomes smaller and enters into the range of the 4000 to 7500 angstroms. The eye discriminates between the wavelength is range by sensation of color. Okay, so whenever it will be comes to the white heart, so at that time, so the eye will be discriminate between these two wavelengths, that means red and white. Okay, the whole of the energy radiated out is not usable for illumination purpose. Okay, leave this one. Okay, so light, so you see, that is total introduction about the light. So there is a lot of introduction about the light. So visible spectrum having the seven colors. Okay, so those seven colors are also having the different wavelengths. I think you are studying about in physics or something subject, that is also coming to the introduction of a light. So this light, this all definitions already you have studied about in, I think, 9th class or 10th class physics subject. Those same definitions will be coming in this topic as a introduction. So coming to the contents, first you can mention a definitions. Okay, there will be a lot of definitions depending upon the illumination concept. First definition is light. Okay, so light is nothing but it is defined as the radiant energy from a hot body that produces visual sensation. Okay, so the energy which is releases from a hot body, whenever you have heated the body, so at that time it releases a visual sensation. Okay, that is nothing but the light. Okay, so visible sensation upon the human eye. Okay, it is expressed in lumen hours. Okay, the light, the units for light is lumen hours. Okay, and it is denoted by the symbol Q. Okay, the light is denoted by the symbol Q. Okay, luminous okay, luminous flux. Okay, so luminous flux is defined as the energy in the form of light waves radiated per second from a luminous body. Okay, luminous body is nothing but the body which is emits the light, that is nothing but the luminous body. So luminous flux is nothing but it is defined as the energy in the form of light waves radiated per second. Okay, per second time how much amount of light waves will be emitted from the luminous body, that is calculated as a luminous flux. Okay, it is represented by the symbol phi. Okay, and it is measured in a lumens. Okay, the luminous flux will be denoted with a phi and measured in lumens. Okay, suppose the luminous body is an incandescent lamp, the total electrical power input to the lamp is not converted into the luminous flux. Some of the power lost to the condenser convert as a fraction of luminous flux. Okay, this is for example of luminous flux. Okay, so later you have discussing about the different types of lamps. In the lamps also you can get the incandescent lamps. This is not necessary example. So just you can know the definition. Luminous flux, it is defined as the energy in the form of light waves radiated per second from the luminous body is nothing but the luminous flux. It is represented by the phi. So here symbols and units are mentioned compulsory. Okay, luminous flux is denoted by the phi and the units are lumens. Okay, see here for example you can take a one lamp. Okay, here whenever you can give a power input, so at that time it gives a luminous flux, radiant flux, that is nothing but the luminous flux. Okay, power loss at non-luminous flux. So that means the entire power, whenever you can switch on the light, at that time entire light will not reaches, only some amount of light will be maybe wastes, that is nothing but the, so that means which amount of luminous, so that means which amount of radiant energy you can get per second is nothing but luminous flux. So non-luminous flux means that will be power lost by the non-luminous flux. That power lost due to the conduction and convection process. So this condensation and convection I will explain later. Okay.
Next one is radiant efficiency. Okay, so radiance efficiency means, okay, see, when an electric current is passed through a conductor, some heat is produced due to I square R loss, which increases temperature of the conductor. At low temperature, conductor radiates energy in the form of heat waves, but very high temperature radiates energy in the form of light waves as well as heat waves. Radiant efficiency is defined as the ratio of energy radiated in the form of light produces sensation of vision to the total energy radiated out by the luminous body. See, when, so previously I am says that whenever, so whenever switch on the light, so at that time the total energy will be radiated by the body. But so total energy radiated from the body, but some amount of energy will be radiated as a light. Okay, so here radiant efficiency is nothing but energy radiated in the form of light to the energy radiated by the body. Okay, so that means total energy radiated by the body and the energy radiated in the form of light. So these two, the ratio between these two factors is nothing but the radiant efficiency. Plane angle. Okay, so this is very, very important. Plane angle. A plane angle is the angle subtended at a point in a plane by converging lines. Okay, see, here light is nothing but in the form of a waves. Okay, so that means light is in the form of a so many waves. So if suppose you can take any two light waves, that means any two lines. For suppose this is one light and this is one. This is one light ray and this is another light ray. Whenever these two lines are converging at a one point, that means this is one light ray and this is another light ray. These two light rays are converging at a point O. So at that time it is makes a some angle. That angle is nothing but a plane angle. Okay, a plane angle is an angle subtended at a point. That means subtended at a point in a plane. So in any one plane, so the angle subtended at a point by converging two lines. Okay, these are the two lines. By converging two lines is nothing but the plane angle. Okay, plane angle is denoted by a Greek letter theta and is usually measured in degrees or radians. Okay, so plane angle is nothing but a plane angle is the angle subtended at a point by converging the two lines. It is denoted by theta and its units are radians or degrees. Okay, see, so this is the theta. Okay, so this is nothing but the plane angle. Okay, so one, so it is denoted by it is measured in degrees or radians. So one radian is defined as the angle subtended by an arc of a circle whose length is equal to the radius of the circle. This is the plane angle. This is like a arc of a circle and it seems like a radius of a circle. So here the one radian will be defined as the angle subtended by an arc of a circle whose length by an arc of a circle is equal to the radius of the circle is nothing but the plane angle. Okay, plane angle theta equal to formula is arc by radius. Okay, plane angle will be mentioned as arc by radius. Next one is, first you can discussing about the plane angle. So next one is solid angle. Solid angle is the angle subtended at a point in a space by an area. That is the angle enclosed in a volume formed by the numerous lines lying on the surface meeting at that point. See, solid angle is the angle. See, here, solid angle is the angle subtended at a point. Here the solid angle is subtended at a point in a space by an area. So here all lines are, all light rays are coming from the lamp will make say some area enclosed in the volume, numerous lines lying on the surface. Okay, these all are placing at a one area. By that area you can make a some angle, that is nothing but the solid angle. Solid angle is the angle subtended at a point in a space by an area, that is the angle enclosed in the volume formed by the numerous lines lying on the surface meeting at a point. That is nothing but the solid angle. Solid angle will be denoted with a symbol omega, and it is measured in a stair radians. See, solid angle formula is solid angle omega equal to area by radius square. Okay, so that means here you can represent it as area of the sphere by radius square. Okay, so that is nothing but the formula for solid angle. Solid angle will be measured in stair radians. Okay, so that is nothing but the definition of a solid angle and plane angle. See, here you can obtain a, so the largest solid angle subtended at the center of a sphere. Okay, whenever you have considered a one sphere, the largest solid angle will be subtended at the center of the sphere. Now you can see the relationship between a plane angle and solid angle. Okay, let us consider a curved surface of a spherical segment ABC. See, here you can assume a spherical segment ABC of height h. See, here height will be h. Okay, and radius of the sphere, here you can assume the radius of the sphere will be small r. The surface area of the curved surface of the spherical segment will be, so here the surface area of this curved surface of spherical segment will be ABC is equal to 2 pi r h. Okay, so at that time omega is nothing but formula area of sphere by radius square. Area of sphere 4 r square by r square. So at that time r square will be cancelled. At that time you can get the 4 pi radius. Okay. Okay, this, so here I am says that the largest solid angle subtended at the center of a sphere. So here the center of the sphere, you can get the solid angle will be 4 pi stair radians. So for let us consider a curved surface. Here the slide will be repeated 2 times. Okay, so let us consider the curved surface of a spherical segment ABC of height h and radius of the sphere small r as shown in figure. The surface area of the curved surface of spherical segment will be ABC equal to 2 pi r h. Okay, so from the figure here, see, from the triangle ODA, so this is C, ODA, from this triangle OD equal to R cos theta by 2. So that means here angle will be cos, so this is total plane angle will be theta. So this is at that time only for this triangle the angle will be theta by 2. Okay, so at that time from the cos theta by 2, cos theta by 2 means adjacent side by hypotenuse. Here adjacent side will be OD and hypotenuse will be OA. So OA, so at the time you want OD value. OD equal to OA cos theta by 2. OA value is how much? R. So at that time OD equal to R cos theta by 2. So from this H, okay, H, you want H value. So H you can here write as total radius. This one is R minus, this one is R cos theta by 2. Okay, this one is having angle. See, here you can want H value. Okay, see, this is H. Okay, so here you can write. Okay, see, here you can write. Here you can want this H value. Here you can write OB. OB equal to OD plus BD. Okay, see concentrately in the diagram, OB equal to OD plus BD. Okay, so but here you want which value? H value, BD value. So at the time here you can write how I'll write B, OBD equal to OB minus OD. Okay, OB minus OD. At that time, you can H value. Already, OB value is what? R. OD value, here you can write R cos theta. So, at that time, R minus R cos theta by 2. R, so, at that time, you can common R. At that time, it will becomes 1 minus cos theta by 2. Okay. The surface area of the segment previously here you can write 2 pi r h. Okay, already h value you can get r minus cos theta by 2. Okay, see r of 1 minus cos theta by 2 is nothing but h. So at that time here you can write 2 pi r, already h means h, r into r minus 1 minus cos theta by 2. R into r will becomes r square. But solid angle is nothing but omega equal to area by radius square. Okay, solid angle formula vachesi area by radius square. So at that time here area of the segment will be get a 2 pi r square 1 minus cos theta by 2. Radius means r square. R square will cancel. Finally you can get 2 pi 1 minus cos theta by 2. This is the relationship between a plane angle and solid angle. Okay, omega equal to 2 pi of 1 minus cos theta by 2. Here omega means solid angle, theta means plane angle. Okay, are you understood? See here first you can get a one segment of a sphere. So and this having a radius r at the height of a h. Okay, this is h. So here you want h value. So this is mistakenly coming into only this BD equal to OB minus OD coming here. Okay, but this is in another slide, that is a mistake. Okay, so but here you want h value. So h value, that means h means here what value? BD. You want BD, so at that time you can write OB minus OD. Okay, OB minus OD. So at that time OB value, directly OB value will be R, BD value, OD value will become from the triangle ODA. Okay, from the triangle ODA, you will take the cos theta by 2 value. So at that time here you can get OD equal to R cos theta by 2. Okay, so at that time here you can get H equal, you can common the R value. At that time you can get H 1 minus cos theta by 2. So at that time, okay, so the surface area of the segment previously, that is the formula is 2 pi r h. Okay, in place of h you can obtain previously 1 minus, here mistakenly r will come. Okay, so that is only 1 minus cos theta by 2. 2 pi r in place of h you can write r of 1 minus cos theta by 2. R into r will becomes r square. 2 pi r square 1 minus cos theta by 2. Okay, solid angle formula will be omega equal to area by radius square. Area already you have find out here, 2 pi r square 1 minus cos theta by 2. Radius here you can denote it in the diagram will be small r. So at that time here you can write r square. Okay, here r square will be cancelled. Finally you can get 2 pi of 1 minus cos theta by 2. This is the relationship between the plane angle and solid angle. Omega is nothing but a solid angle and theta is nothing but plane angle. Okay, so here up to now you can see the definitions of a light, luminous flux, plane angle, solid angle and relation between the plane angle and solid angle. Next one is luminance intensity. Okay, luminance intensity in a given direction is defined as the luminous flux emitted by the solid angle. Okay, unit solid angle. Okay, here printing will be mistake. Okay, so luminance intensity in a given direction is defined as the luminous flux emitted by the solid angle. One unit, so whenever you can take one unit solid angle, in that solid angle how much amount of luminance intensity will be, luminous flux will be emitted, that is nothing but the luminance intensity. Okay, see, this is a solid angle omega. So in this solid angle, how much amount of from this is light and light source. Okay, from this light source, here you can take a solid angle. From this light source, in this unit solid angle, how much of luminous flux will be emitted is taken as a luminous intensity. Luminous intensity is denoted with I. So I equal to phi by omega. Phi is nothing but luminous flux. Omega is nothing but solid angle. It is denoted by the symbol I, okay, capital I, and it is usually measured in candela. Okay, let F be the luminous. So luminous flux will be maybe denoted with a capital F or maybe denoted with a phi. Okay, let F be the luminous flux crossing the spherical segment of solid omega. Solid also the luminant intensity is measured in lumens or stray radiance or candela. Okay, it is measured in lumen per stray radian or candela, and it is denoted with capital I. Okay, so and it is denoted with capital I and is equal to phi by omega. Okay, lumen. It is the unit of a luminous flux. It is defined as the luminous emitted by the source of a luminous flux emitted by the source of one candle power per unit solid angle in all directions. Okay. Okay. Lumen. Lumen is nothing but it is a unit of a luminous flux. It is defined as the luminous flux emitted by a source of one candle power per unit solid angle, per unit solid angle, how much amount of candle power of luminous flux is emitted is nothing but lumen. Okay, so lumen equal to candle power of source into solid angle. Okay, so that means lumen equal to solid candle power into omega. The total flux emitted by the source of one candle power is 4 pi lumens. Okay, so the total flux, okay, from one candle power is nothing but how much amount of lumens will be released is nothing but 4 pi lumens. Candle power is nothing but the candle power of a source is defined as the luminous flux lines emitted by that source in a unit solid angle. So that means in one unit solid angle, how much amount of luminous flux will be emitted, that is nothing but the candle power. Okay. So that is the lumen, candle power definition. Illumination. Illumination is the defined as the luminous flux received by the surface per unit area. That means illumination is defined as the luminous flux received by unit surface area. That is nothing but the illumination. So it is usually denoted by the symbol E. Okay, and formula means, so the luminous flux will be denoted with a phi or F. Okay, if you take phi, you can write surface area will be denoted with a capital A. So if you take phi, if you denote luminous flux with phi, at that time you can write phi by A. If suppose you can denote it with F, at that time you can write the formula F by A. Okay, and it is denoted with the symbol E and is measured in lux or lumens per meter square.